Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today, I'm going to speak about my what keeps me motivated to keep on my hijab. I also spoke about this yesterday on my story, and I also got a lot of questions to speak about hijab, everything related to it. Yeah, today I wanted to share my motivation. I first of all want to tell you guys that I'm not claiming that my way of doing things is the right way, but I'm just sharing my personal experience and my motivation and my way of thinking. Also, since I'm going to speak a lot in this video, I want to excuse if you're new here. Yes, I'm from the Netherlands, so I'm not a native English speaker. So I sometimes struggle a little bit with finding the right words, but yeah, so let's start. So I haven't prepared anything or thought about what I was going to say. So I'm just going to, like, just as if you were my friends and asking me right now what keeps me motivated. The moment I decided to wear my hijab, it was 1 week after I said the shahada. I'm wearing my hijab since February 2 years, so right now 2.5 years, and I've been converted now to Islam for 2.5 years. So alhamdulillah, my life has been so much better. I'm so much happier, and I now have so much more understanding of life, so that's really nice. So when I started to do research in Islam and everything, I went to the mosque every time to learn. I took lessons, I also took Arabic class and everything, and every time when I went to the mosque, I needed to wear a scarf. I really did not know how to wear it. It looked ridiculous, actually, if I look back now, but it felt so good to be there and to wear it. And every time when I went home wearing the clothes, I hated to take it off. I hated that. And also at one point I ordered on AliExpress some scarves. Meanwhile, I did not even said the shahada yet, but I find it just so beautiful. I was looking at all these Instagrammers, like hijabi Instagrammers, wearing their modest clothing and their hijab and everything. And I was just looking at it like, wow, I really want that. So I ordered those scarves. I started to try them on in secret in my room, because no one around me did know I was actually that far in doing research and that busy with Islam as I actually was, and I really loved how that felt. I converted to Islam pretty quick after I did research. By the way, I never regret it, because some people, this is also one thing I wanted to speak about. A lot of girls that want to convert or are doing research in Islam contact me. They are like, I want to say the shahada, but I think I'm maybe going too fast or doing things too fast. My opinion is that it's never too fast. Well, you need to feel like you're ready for it, of course. I feel like if you feel like this is real, this is, I now believe and I understand. For me, that was enough to be ready, and I never regret saying the shahada that fast. And then 1 week after I converted, I went to a sister that I met in the mosque, which is a Dutch girl or woman, actually, who is converted, I think, for 12 years back. And she invited me to speak about Islam. I also asked her if she could teach me how to pray. So I went there, and I went there with a scarf. And she's like, oh, are you wearing the scarf now? And by the way, I remember that day that I said the shahada, and I went outside with my clothes, everything, because I was in the mosque. And it felt just so wrong to just take it all off again. It felt just so good with my scarf and just my dress and everything. I started to kind of feel ashamed without it. Sounds really weird, because I'm not saying to the women that are not wearing a scarf that they need to feel ashamed. Absolutely not. But that's the feeling I got. So yeah. And then I went to this lady, and she asked me, like, are you wearing it right now? And I was like, no, but I'm just trying to, it feels just really good to wear it. And I'm not sure if I'm doing this too fast and everything. And then she started to speak with me about this. And this is the thing what keeps me always motivated, why I'm explaining this whole story. And I hope I can say it the same way as she did. Let's say in a store, you want to buy a diamond. You want to have a diamond. This diamond is just not for everyone to get. It's expensive. It's protected. I mean, like, You can never just grab it, take it, and just hold it and whatever. It's mostly just protected underneath glass. It's just something precious and unique, and I don't know the right words for it right now. And it's just untouchable, and it's not for everyone to touch. It's protected. So let's say you're that diamond. You just want to protect yourself. You don't want everyone to see your beauty. You don't want to share that with everyone because this here is just special and you want to keep that for yourself. I hope this really made sense. That's kind of the thing, like in my mind, I want to be that diamond. I want to be that thing that is not for everyone to see, whatever, you know? So that's one thing. Also, if anyone is watching this who doesn't understand why women are wearing a hijab, maybe they think they only do this for their husbands because they have to. Well, this is one of my reasons, and this is also one of the reasons in Islam. It's not only for a husband. I don't even have a husband or anything. I'm wearing this just for myself. And this is just also one of the reasons why we want to protect ourselves and why we want to cover ourselves. So that's one of my biggest motivations. Then the second thing is that I'm always thinking, keep praying. Really, whenever I start to struggle with my prayer, when I start to skip some prayers or some days that I even don't pray, in those times, out of nowhere, I start to hate on my scarf and the clothing I wear. And I'm looking on Instagram, and I'm just like, all those beautiful girls with those hair, with that hair, I'm just like, I can also be that. I can also have my hair out and wear that clothing. Whatever, those kind of thoughts go through my mind. And I'm starting to speak to my friends like, I hate this thing on my head. I want to take it off. I hate it. But I always keep strong. I always keep it on because I know I will regret that I'm going to take it off. But and I'm always just like, keep thinking about it, not do things too fast. That's the first thing. And then I start to notice, like, it's always whenever I skip my prayers, when I'm not doing my prayers. And then when I remind that, I'm like, okay, I'm going to pray right now and I'm going to make dua to make it easier for me. And right away, I'm just like, alhamdulillah, I'm so happy with this. I'm so proud of myself. I feel just more confidence, I hope I pronounced that right, with this, that I am so strong to wear this, especially in the environments around us. And then I feel just so strong that I can wear this, especially that you're pleasing Allah every day and you get so much hasanat with this. And then I'm just always just like, yes, I kept it on again. Because every time when I struggle, I keep it on and I'm every time happy when I kept it on. And then there's the second thing I always ask myself. Like, is it really worth it to take it off? I'm always asking myself, like, what weighs more? I'm going to go to what the reasons why I should take it off. I can only come up with one thing, and that is to feel more beautiful. That's it. And then I go to everything, the reasons why I should keep it on. I don't even know if I should go through them because the list is very long. Okay, let's just say some really important things is that, first of all, you know how much hasanat we get every day for wearing it. And then let's say you get married one day, inshallah, you can just have that beauty and share just only with your husband. I find that really romantic and really beautiful. I find that part also just really beautiful. And then the fifth thing is that you are beautiful with your hijab. You are beautiful. It's just so beautiful. So I can, this list here is just so long. So that's always what I ask myself, like, it's just not worth it. And also, when I have children later, I would like to be that example for them that I'm wearing it. I think if they see the mom wearing it, it's not always the case, of course, and I haven't experienced it because I've been raised as an atheist with a Dutch mom. But I feel like it's just a little bit easier when your mother and your surroundings are also wearing it, instead of when your whole family is not wearing a hijab and then you are at a point that you want to wear a scarf. Not even your mother is wearing it, so it's maybe a little bit of a harder thing. not that I'm wearing it for that, but I mean, like, I want to also be that example for my daughters, inshallah. And I'm also always telling myself, like, why am I actually here on this earth? And also, I'm always thinking, like, yeah, maybe I'm taking it off right now in my mind, like, I'm going to wear it again in a few years. But you know, you never know when it's your last day. And I want to die. Whoa, that sounds really scary. But I want to die with my scarf on. I want to wear it on my last day. Maybe I'm sharing. So this is my way of thinking. And maybe I'm saying really weird things. But these things keep me really motivated. So let me know if this is weird or if you're also thinking like this or if this helps. I would like to know. And then one more thing. There's this fly and he's making a lot of sound, but I hope you guys don't hear that. So you know why I have all these flies in my house? It's because my neighbors let their dogs poop in their garden, which is next to my window. And they all, every summer, they fly into my house. You know what? I have a house. Alhamdulillah. I'm trying to stay positive, okay? Okay, I don't have this struggle. Alhamdulillah, I did a little bit in the beginning when I started with Islam and everything, but right now I don't have that struggle. But I'm getting like also messages about what about family not supporting you about hijab or that are against Islam or whatever. The thing is what I did, I don't know what happened to me in the time that I converted, but I was in this high level of iman. I just thought by myself, because I had some people around me saying like, oh, you're going so fast, you should not do that, you should think about it. Or some people like, oh, this is just a phase of her life. And then also people that came over at our house that I've known my whole life, but that are just not Muslims. When I just started to do research and everything, they were just starting these discussions with me or debates, or I don't know how to call that, but they are just like, yeah, and how do you explain this? And are you going to, I hope you're not going to be an extremist and those kind of things. And I'm just like, okay, yeah, if that's how you think, I think it's just peace. The religion is just peace. And but if you want to think like that, it's your opinion. I'm just not in for a discussion. If you want to have information, if you want me to share some information, if you have questions, I would love to answer them. But if you are just trying to make me rethink it, it's not going to work because I know what I'm doing. I just stayed calm and in my mind, in the back of my mind, I'm just like, yeah, but you don't know what I know. You just don't know what I know. I wish you knew. I'm not going to change the way I think to please a human because their opinion just does not matter. We are here not for the people. We are not here to make them happy. And also on our last day, think just of the day of judgment and then think of their opinion. Okay, this is a really hard subject because also the struggle of your mother or your father or your whole family just disowning you kind of, or just not wanting anything to do with you anymore because of Islam. It is really hard. The harder the test is, the harder we get rewarded for this. So if you stay with Islam, if you stay strong, you keep wearing your hijab, you keep wearing it, your clothes, or you keep following Islam, you get rewarded the most. So it is a really, really hard, but also this is why you get tested. You need to see it as a test, and also you need to see this whole life as a test. You need to understand why we are here and that their opinion does matter because you love them. But at the end of the day, day of judgment, they are not able to help you there. So what I, in my mind, I was just like, I don't like that you are not supporting me, but that's it. I'm going to follow this because you're not going to help me to heaven. I want to go to heaven, you know, I'm on my own there. So I'm going to do why I'm here. I'm going to do this and I'm going to keep strong. Alhamdulillah, my whole family is now supporting me. My mother even did 2 times Ramadan with me. My sister did the last time Ramadan with us. And my father, I had this Ramadan also with my father, with my mother. My 2 best friends converted to Islam. Alhamdulillah, Meanwhile, when I just started, I felt like I was so alone. I really feel like I did du'as so much for my family and everyone around me. Allah just listened to all my du'as and I'm so thankful. And that made my iman so much stronger. Also, my best friend just started wearing her hijab 4 months back. And she converted 4 months after I converted. So she's just wearing it. And she was just one of the girls that was just so... She was just really scared of people's opinion around her. And also, I also told her this, like, after a while, everyone will get used to that. And if they really love you, they will support you. If they see that that makes you happy, everyone around you will be happy for you when you're happy. And yeah, so she's wearing it right now and everyone is just supporting her and is just so used to her wearing it. It's not even a thing anymore. You need to know that maybe some people will at the beginning just like will be like, whoa, like what's happening? Maybe they will be a little bit negative, but then stay strong and show them that it makes you happy. And that's just important for the people that you love. And then everyone will get used to it. It's not even a topic anymore where you will speak about. This is just so basic now for me and everyone around me. But whoever is watching my video right now and wants to wear it, but is thinking like, I'm not perfect yet, so I'm not able to wear this yet, I want to tell you that this here doesn't mean you are perfect. Maybe for me, it's easier to wear a scarf than another thing, another struggle. Maybe that I'm struggling with something else. There can be a girl that is just not wearing the scarf yet, but is just so good from within. Doesn't mean that she is less better than the girl with the scarf. So if you feel like you want to wear it, but you feel like you're not perfect yet or not good enough yet to wear this, go wear it. If you want to wear it, then please go wear it because you will not regret it. This video is all over the place, but I hoped I motivated someone and I helped someone. I'm going to be reading all your comments and replying to them, chatting with you guys. I love that. I would love that. And I'm always just so happy whenever I used to have my Snapchat open and girls that I have been speaking a lot with about wearing the scarf, and they were before scared, and then they sent me after a few months a picture that they are saying that they are wearing the scarf right now and that I really helped them with that to just make that step. So if I could help anyone with that, please contact me, put it in the comments, whatever. I would love to chat with you guys. So I was editing this video and I totally forgot that I wanted to do a giveaway with these two beautiful scarves. So this is the first scarf and this one here is the second. So I want to give that away to two winners. So make sure to put your email or your Instagram so that I can DM you to let you know that you're the winner. So what you need to do is just turn on your notification bell, then comment done, and yeah. So I'm going to contact the giveaway winner on Monday, the two giveaway winners actually, and then you can show me a screenshot if you turn on the notification bell. And I will make sure to announce them in the comments here down below. So good luck and